There is a message from National Treasures. Please check it. It's been knocked about a bit, but that's to be expected after 2,300 years. Yet scorched and battered, though it undoubtedly is, on the whole, the ravages of time have been rather kind to this sheet of bronze. Look behind the dents and marks, and you can still make out the gold and silver lines of what might be the earliest surviving architectural drawing, the plan of a proposed mausoleum for King Toa, ruler of the state of Zhongshan during the Warring States period. In fact, his existence is only known from inscriptions on these bronzes, which record that he dispatched troops to the state of Yin to help put down an uprising. The expedition was evidently successful and commemorated with a cauldron made from the spoils of war taken on the campaign. Located in what is now Hubei province, sandwiched between two very powerful states, the affairs of her neighbors were very much Zhongshan's business in those turbulent times. The bronze etching shows that King Toa's ambitions weren't restricted to this life. Laid to rest in this palatial tomb complex, he would be a mighty king in death too. It was an ambitious scheme. The precise size and shape of each building, as well as the entire site, specified on this 96 by 48 centimeter drawing. The drawings and plans are one thing, reality another. It's only when you take a look at the proposed site from the air that you start to get a real sense of what the king had in mind. From his palatial tomb, Toa would be at the center of this miniature kingdom of the dead. Sadly, perhaps, it was not meant to be. Zhongshan was destined to be wiped from the face of the earth. Only the tombs of the king and his queen were ever completed, poignant monuments to a king's thwarted ambitions. Gone, but not quite forgotten. 2,300 years later, the bronzes bearing Toa's name resurfaced, a reminder of both of a long-forgotten footnote in the history of the Warring States period and the technological sophistication of ancient China. What we see here is bronze of the finest quality, the work of a master craftsman with the most advanced bronze casting techniques at his fingertips. Stunningly decorated, it has a peculiarly contemporary feel to it. Designed as a modular piece, it consists of individual parts, ready to be disassembled, boxed up, taken away at a moment's notice. This tiger is exquisitely well observed, the weight of the beast apparently displaced by the power of the bite inflicted on the frail, fragile deer. It's also the ideal shape for a stand, designed to support two fold-away screens. These bronze tent fixtures are another good example of Warring States modular design, a demonstration, perhaps, of just how important portability was back then. In a sense, these items embody the spirit of those times. Invention born of necessity, flexibility essential to surviving the ceaseless conflict of the Warring States period, a time when, for rulers and ruled alike, life was a constant battle, peace and repose, only to be found in death.